बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, ओपन योर बुक ऑक्सफोर्ड रीडिंग सर्कल चैप्टर नंबर 14, हुक बाय अ बुक ऑन पेज नंबर 110। इट्स अ पोएम, सो लेट्स बिगिन। जुमामा सेट बाय द टेली वेटिंग फॉर 9 o'clock। हर प्रोग्राम वुड स्टार्ट वेरी शॉर्टली बट देन शी हर्ड अ नॉक। हु कैन दैट बी, वॉन्ट जुमामा, राइजिंग टू गो एंड सी। It's almost time to my favorite. Gosh, already 8:43. There in the doorway before her stood a man with a nose like a hook. She wasn't at all very certain if he was Dad's friend or a crook. "Hello," said Jemima. "Who are you?" The hook made no reply. He took from his pocket a packet and passed it to her with a sigh. "Thank you," said Jemima, smiling. "Tell me, who is the parcel for?" The hook said nothing but pointed at her, then vanished from the door. Puzzled, Jemima took the pack, examining how it was bound. She tore the paper, snapped the string inside a wondrous book she found. She opened it and, turning pages, made herself cozy on the floor, began to read for ages and ages, and before long the clock chimed 4. So in this poem, basically there are two characters, that is Jemima and the other man whose nose is like a hook. So in this poem, Jemima was eagerly waiting to watch her favorite show, which was about to begin. Just then she heard a knock on the door. She pondered that at this time, who can be on the door? Either he could be a dad's friend or someone she could not trust. Like it could be a criminal or a fake or scam or fraud type person. Just then she reached the door and she saw a tall man whose nose looked like a hook. She asked him who was he, but that person did not reply. Ed took a parcel out of his pocket and gave it to her and disappeared as if he was not there. Jemima was examining the parcel she had in her hand. And she took the ribbons and paper off. She found it was a book. She began to read and could not stop reading till the bell rang by 4 o'clock. She found that book so interesting that she could not stop reading it and even did not notice that she missed her favorite program, which she was waiting for so desperately.